All right, everybody. We're back with another episode of Star Wars: The Old Republic. Sorry, I got lost trying to get here. I feel really bad about getting lost trying to find the starport. All right. So, here we go on the road again. First off, he wished to speak to us.
My lord, I have settled into my quarters and fully acquainted myself with the ship. I am at your disposal.
I want you on a persistent state of alert, Captain.
I won't disappoint, my lord. I am fully trained in all aspects of operating this vessel. I can navigate and pilot it to perfection.
Get to your station, then.
Right away, my lord.
Is that all he wanted? Okay.
You have done well, my apprentice. Telecon eliminated and Lord Rathori dispelled. This will be a day long remembered. The loss of Haladrol Sitsun is unfortunate, but the ends far justify the means.
She served you honorably, Master.
I had a soft spot for her as well. You have successfully eliminated both of my compromised agents. The time has come to set our sights on Noman Carr and his gifted Padawan. It seems our adversary is of like mind. Your efforts have not gone unnoticed. Noman Carr has been busy.
Enlighten me, Master.
It appears your ship is being tracked. A very sophisticated sensor is reporting your every movement. I've traced the signal to a spaceport in a sector not far from you. I'm sure Noman Carr is involved.
Send me to this spaceport. Perhaps Carr is there, and I can end this.
Noman Carr is a master of the Jedi arts. Do not take him lightly. I've sent the coordinates to your mainframe. Head there immediately, dock with the station, and make a lasting impression.
Okay. Well, obviously I'm going to take the one that says it's an upgrade. Yeah. Go ahead and equip that.
What does family mean to you? I mean, does it have to be the people you're actually related to?
When you are close to people, they become family. Sometimes, whether you want them to or not.
Cute. I'm going to take that as a compliment. When I was working for Noctrayan, doing the pirate thief thing, he had a daughter my age, Risha. It wasn't like Noct was super sweet to her or anything. But he'd call her princess, and I wished I was her.
You've only spoken of a mother and sister. What happened to your father?
Dead, enslaved, disappeared. We never really knew. Maybe that's why I wanted to be Risha. Risha was smart and strong. She knew how to do everything around the ship. And I went everywhere with her. Suddenly I had a sister again. For years it was Risha and me against the galaxy and anyone who gave us grief.
Did you drift apart? Start to fight?
Nothing like that. Eventually, Nock hatched some secret plan that I couldn't be a part of. One that apparently got them both killed. But for a while there, I really really was happy. Enough of that.
Okay. Interesting. Not that I care, but interesting. Why?
You wish to speak? Yes, my lord. I wanted to update you on the condition of your ship. It has responded extremely well to my optimizations. I'm pleased to report that we are operating at peak efficiency.
I'm glad to hear it. Keep up the good work.
I fully intend to, my lord.
Your demeanor makes me tense, Captain. Work on loosening up.
I see. Actually, my lord, I don't see. Is that an order, or are you testing my professionalism?
I don't make requests, Quinn. Consider everything out of my mouth to be mandatory.
Then I will do my best to, loosen up. Permission to speak freely, my lord.
Go ahead, Captain.
There's a reason I was languishing on Balmora before you arrived. A decade ago, I served under Moff Broisk at the Battle of Drakenwell. Moff Broisk made a critical oversight that brought the fleet to the brink of complete defeat. I ignored his order and turned the tide to victory.
I take it the Moff took exception to that.
Your intuition is flawless, my lord. Broisk took credit for the reversal, which is fine. But then he caught Marshall. Barris assigned me to Balmora, or my career would have been over. Moff Broisk has blocked every transfer and promotion I've been up for since.
I have no tolerance for fools like this, Moff.
I could say more about him, my lord, but my point is made. I serve you now, I have no regrets. I'll return to my duties.
Bruh.
My lord, I have been working on something in my spare time. You may be interested.
Go ahead, regale me.
Years ago, I was zeroing in on a notorious SIS agent called Volorin. When Moff Broisk recalled me to the Battle of Drakenwell, I had the spy cornered. I briefed Broisk so that he could send someone else to take Volorin out. He ignored the opportunity.
What is so important about this Volorin?
Over the years, he has single-handedly caused more damage to the Empire than any other Republic operative. One missed opportunity has led to a decade of unnecessary losses. I know Volorin's signature. And by tracking his accomplishments, I've picked up his scent.
It is imperative that you track him down.
Very good, my lord. I'll keep you abreast of my progress.
Alright, no more from you? Thank you. Bruh, he came up quick. Okay. It looks small. I hope it is. Really?
The fight is upon us.
What did I move? Like, I accidentally removed something. That's a passive. Oh.
This day.
Bruh. Yes. I just saw him drop a lightsaber and I was like, okay. See, I see the silver and gold, and I assume that they're going to be the harder ones to kill. I like how this is stuck at 25. Bro. Stop it. Cool.
What seems to be the trouble, Hiroshio? Tell me why you're so concerned.
Master Khan, you promised we would be undetected, but the ship we've been tracking for you is here.
Calm your fear, Hiroshio. It will not serve you. I will speak with your visitor when the time comes.
The time is upon you. I am here. Say your piece.
Okay. You never told me we'd be tracking a Sith.
You were provided the details necessary to perform your duties. Now please, remain quiet. Sith, I presume you are Darth Barriss's new apprentice. I am Jedi Master Norman Carr. Do you know me?
You are my master's sworn enemy.
Barriss and I like to keep tabs on each other, so when I heard of a new apprentice, I investigated. These men were merely monitoring the equipment, following orders. There's no need for bloodshed here.
I feel an overwhelming need for bloodshed.
Hiroshio, defend yourself. The Sith attacks. Excessive display. Those men were defenseless and unarmed.
Their deaths are on your head, Carr.
Such a sad attempt to deflect responsibility, Sith. I shall honor Hiroshio and his men's lives by dedicating myself to thwarting you and your master.
You will fail, and they will have died for nothing.
Your confidence is unfounded. Soon you will realize that. It calms me that you and Barriss have no idea what you're up against.
Your pupil's powers are a sham. She is leading you on a witch hunt.
You know more than I thought. Barriss, no doubt, is after my Padawan. How unfortunate. I've kept her identity and location a secret. So you and your master are just feeling your way in the dark. But my Padawan is of supreme importance to me in the Jedi Order. I will not let harm come to her.
I would expect nothing less.
In that case, I shall exceed your expectations, my friend. You're about to find out how resourceful I can be. These troopers are among the Republic's finest. Surrender, and the Jedi Council will be lenient.
I find that preposterous.
And you leave me no choice. Men, take the Sith in by any means necessary.
Okay.
It seems Darth Barriss has found himself a singularly vicious weapon in you. This experience has given me valuable insight. I'll be prepared for you next time, Sith.
I'll wait right here, Carr. Come and face me now.
Jedi do not seek out a fight. My place is by my Padawan's side, teaching her the ways of the Force and honing her talents. I will do everything in my power to keep her hidden from you.
I'm talking to a dead man.
Until we meet again.
Really? I just noticed I could blow that up and I figured I'd do it. Why couldn't he have just been there? To prolong the story. Oh, it's just a medical droid down here. Is he shooting at me from the second story? Okay, that was weird. That was extremely odd that he was able to shoot at me from the second story. I don't think the game understood what was going on in that one.
Apprentice, now that Noman Carr realizes that we seek his Padawan, there's no time to waste. He claimed the girl on her home planet of Alderaan, and she trained on Tatooine. I have agents on both planets digging up leads. Find the people who know this girl. Someone means enough to her to make her come out of hiding.
I will obliterate everything she knows.
I am confident this is how we will prevail. The Padawan's training is incomplete. She is susceptible. The anguish, of course, will flush her out, and you will kill her and her master.
Perhaps the Padawan can be turned.
Her power would be a great asset, yes. Put through enough torment, she may reveal her base nature. But we must be cautious. The danger she represents is extreme. As long as she lives, she is a threat. Seduction to the dark side should be left to masters. If there is even a sliver of doubt in your heart, it can backfire.
I will be mindful, Master.
You have yet to face a Jedi Master. The righteousness and passionless demeanor is nauseating. And Noman Carr is no ordinary master. Confronting him, you will find profound fortitude and hate, or you will falter.
I will not falter. My hate knows no bounds.
Just be sure it serves you. Be off, then. Tatooine and Alderaan await. Discover this Padawan's identity and destroy her.
All right, then. So, Tatooine or Alderaan? So Tatooine's where she did her training. No, Tatooine is where she was. Yeah, Tatooine's where she did her training. So Alderaan will be most likely actually be where she's supposed to be, but that's 28 through... So this is closer to my level range right now, so we're gonna go there. Because if I go to Alderaan...
Sons of Tatooine await you, apprentice. I've gleaned much since our interrogation of the Republic agent here on Dromund Kaas. I am certain Nomon Kaar brought this gifted Padawan to Tatooine to train with a legendary master named Yonlok. Years ago, I urged the Dark Council to hunt down and destroy this Jedi. They refused. And Yonlok went into hiding on Tatooine.
What should I do with him once I track him down?
Yonlok is the one who brought the Padawan's powers into expression. Now they share a special bond. Find him and destroy him.
I will bring the old man to his knees.
Nomon Kaar shelters his prize, so we will draw her out by destroying everything she loves. My servant Sharok Biv will guide you. She's eccentric, an acquired taste, but give her the benefit of the doubt.
As you decree, my lord.
That is all.
Okay, so... let's go put some stuff in cargo real quick. And leave that... I think that's it. Just out of curiosity. Okay, he looks better now. Outside of the gear that I have him in. But I still like my normal attire.
You're looking fit and deadly, as always.
And with that, guys, we're going to call it an end to the episode. Bye!
Showing who's in charge. Call me